and so forth, is the ultimate aim is peaceful coexistence.
Yes.
So we will do that.
Yes.
We will do that, and we will make sure that everybody comes in line with the
recommendation. Thank you so much, Honorable Minister.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. That was Honorable Minister of Information, and we have just arrived His Holiness Pope Francis. He has just come. We are expecting the President Salva Kiir Mayardit alongside Vice President Dr. Riek Machar and other government officials. They will be seeing him off, giving the farewell. And of course, viewers, His Holiness just arrived, and few seconds from now, we'll be seeing him boarding this Italian Airways, the plane that will take him for all like direct to Italy, where of course, that is Vatican, where he will finally say bye-bye to South Sudan. And of course, viewers, with me is my colleague, Mawe Kwal. We are just here to brief you, to tell you everything that is happening. Mawe Kwal, welcome.
Thank you, Gori Anthony. شكرا جزيلا الزميل العزيز Gori Anthony. واهلا ومرحبا بكم مشاهدي الكرام. نحن هنا في مطار جوبا الدولي حيث نودع الضيف الذي زار البلاد وهو العبر الحبر الاعظم بابا فرانسيس الذي زار البلاد واجرى لقاءات بين المسؤولين من بينهم رئيس الجمهوريه سالفا كير مايارديت ونوابه وكذلك ادى صلوات بتركيا وكذلك التقى بنازحين بقاعه الحريه وكذلك اقام قداس بساحه دكتور جون غارانغ امس السبت واليوم صباح اليوم بساحه دكتور جون غارانغ والان نحن بمطار جوبا الدولي مشاهدي الكرام كان هذه لحظه تاريخيه للبلاد حيث زار بابا فرانسيس البلاد وحث المواطنين والحكومه على ضروره العمل من اجل السلام وتحقيق الرفاهيه لشعب جنوب السودان واستقلال الموارد التي تسخر بها البلاد إذن نحن ومعكم نتابع هذه اللحظات التاريخية حيث يغادر بعد قليل بابا فرانسيس وضيوف الكرام الذين حلوا في البلاد على مدار 3 أيام إذن كونوا معنا وسنكون معكم في هذه اللحظة التاريخية إذن نحن في مطار جوبا الدولي وننقل إلى حضراتكم فعاليات عودة الطائرة البابوية إلى العاصمة الإيطالية روما بعد قليل ستقلع هذه الطائرة والبلاد أكثر سعادة بهذه الزيارة التاريخية التي كانت ستكون لها مدلولات سياسية واجتماعية واقتصادية على مستوى البلاد حسب الإفادات التي تلقيناها هنا في أسد بي سي ومن خروج المواطنين الذين خرجوا حيث خرج مدينة جوبا لأول مرة في تاريخها وهي تستقبل بابا فرانسيس عندما اصطفوا على جنبات الطرق الرئيسة في مدينة جوبا وكذلك أمس عندما شاهدنا حشدا جماهيريا كبير بساحة دكتور جون غارانغ واليوم كذلك الذين أدوا صلاة الشكر والأحد اليوم بساحة دكتور جون غارانغ إذن المشاهدون الكرام لازلنا نحن وأنتم نتابع هذه التي شهدتها البلاد نحن هنا الآن بمطار حيث الطائرة البابوية ستقلع إلى العاصمة الإيطالية روما المشاهدون الكرام نحن هنا في مطار جوبا الدولي حيث نتابع معكم التاريخية التي شهدتها البلاد منذ ولم تشهد البلاد منذ استقلالها حيث زار البابا فرانسيس جنوب السودان وهذه الزيارة التي كانت قد تأجل في يوليو من العام الماضي ويتم تأكيدها اليوم حيث التقى بالنازحين والتقى برئيس الجمهورية ونوابه وكذلك التقى أو كذلك أقام صلوات بكنيسة الكاثوليكية وأمس واليوم أدى الدكتور جون غارانغ إذن نتابع معكم هذه اللحظات التاريخية وكونوا معنا نحن ننقل إليكم هذه المشاهد من مطار جوبا
You're still watching us live from Juba. You're still watching us live from Juba International Airport, viewers, where we are in the departure of His Holiness Pope Francis. This is one of the great and unique events in the history of the country, and the whole leadership of the country, led by His Excellency President Salva Kiir Mayardit, they are actually here at Juba International Airport, where we're expecting His Holiness to be departing right now. As you could see, viewers, we have got his accompanied him to this very unique nation, that is South Sudan. As you could see, they are just off the Pope Francis along with his accompanying delegation. You could just see them. These are some of the church leaders that have accompanied His Holiness to the country, and they are just about to board the plane. That is Italian Airways. That will take along about 6.5 hours to reach viewers. We remember that there was massive turn-up from people from all walks of life, government officials. Everyone was here to receive His Holiness, and he has done so many work in this nation. He has preached the gospel to the needy. He has talked to the IDPs. He has also went ahead and met with the government officials, and most importantly, advising them in the nation above their interests, and ensure that the country is above every other political leader interest. And they talked on how the leaders of South Sudan need to unite their ranks and work together to ensure that this country that they describe as one of the blessed country, which is remembered by God in the Bible, has to move from this level to another level. Viewers, were just relaying to you this the religious leaders that came along with His Holiness. They are just about to board the Italian Airways, as we're expecting him to be leaving shortly from here, from Juba International Airport. At around exactly 11:30, he will be boarding his plane, and then we are expecting about for him to reach Italy. This has been one of the unique events in the history of us who turn up at Mizilium. There were so many people who couldn't leave Dr. John Garang Mizilium. They had to be there and sleep over in order to be able to catch up with the prayers that was held, the ecumenical prayer that was held this morning. And this shows that South Sudanese are for peace, stability, for prosperity. They are yearning together. And this is what the people are expecting, that upon the completion of this mission, as he leaves Juba, we are expecting that the blessings of God reign over this country, and everyone has to understand that it is a collective responsibility of all of us to ensure that this nation is moved to another level. I will relay to you the His Holiness, with the leadership of the country, giving a final blessings to the leadership and Salva Kiir Mayardit, Dr. Riek Machar, the first vice president, and His Holiness is the final touches, the final prayers, and the final words, encouragement, that the message he has left behind shouldn't just be gone in vain, but they should put it into action. And that is what is happening. As we have seen, honorable members of the Cabinet Affairs, alongside with other government officials, the Minister of Peace Building, Minister of Wildlife, Minister of General Education, as well as Minister of Transport, they are all along standing, waiting to be able to see off Pope Francis. Let me just get my friend Mawai Kwal, as we are about to give you a highlight from also one of the religious leaders, to be able to give us the whole summary of what happened. Let me have my colleague Mawai Kwal to give you some highlight, as I give you somebody to highlight about the visit of the Pope.
إذن المشاهدون الأكارم، السلام عليكم مرة أخرى من مطار جوبا الدولي، حيث نحن الآن في لحظات تاريخية، حيث سيغادر بعد قليل البابا فرانسيس الذي زار البلاد وأجرى لقاءات كما سبقنا وقلنا أنه أجرى لقاءات مع رئيس الجمهورية، وكذلك التقى بأعضاء الحكومة، وكذلك التقى برجال الدين وقادة الكنيسة الكاثوليكية بكنيسة سانت تريزا بكاتور، وكذلك التقى بنازيين بقاعة الحرية. وأمس السبت أجرى صلوات عامة بساحة الدكتور جون غارن، واليوم كذلك صباح اليوم أدى صلاة الشكر أو صلاة الشكر بساحة الدكتور جون غارن. والآن نحن بمطار جوبا الدولي مشاهدي الكرام، حيث رئيس الجمهورية معنا اليوم اللي يودع وما أنوابه هذا الضيف الكبير الذي زار البلاد وسيكون لزيارته مدلولات تاريخية في تاريخ البلاد. سعداء ينضم إلي، سعداء مشاهدي الكرام أن ينضم إلي في هذه اللحظة التاريخية واحد من قيادات الكنيسة، مرحبا بك.
شكرا جزيلا للشعب تجنوب السودان لهذه الفرصة، فرصة زيارة عظيم الختام الليلة. إننا كشعب تجنوب السودان نقول شكرا لله لهذه الهجة السلام، الهجاز السلام جاء يسلم معنا في جنوب السودان، يسلم معنا في وطننا دي. فنقول شكرا لله، إن شاء الله يرد كزيارة يجب لنا السلام الشامل، يجب لنا كل الخير وبركات في هنا بنلقى في جنوب السودان. فدي رسالة دي نقول الختام دي حصل يا حصل في مطار جوبا البرشوية البابا فاتيكان ورئيس المطار الكنيسة أسكوفية في بريطانيا ورئيس الكنيسة اسكتلنديا قائمين الليلة كختام. هم ماشيين لكن قلوبهم معنا هنا في جنوب السودان، هم بخلي جنوب السودان لكن هم لسه معنا في الروح في الصلاة، نستلم الصلاة لعدم الشعب يلقى السلام، السلام جاي من الله، ما سلامت الإنسان لكن سلام الله البدور بسعيد رسالتي لشعب جنوب السودان. فنستمر في شارع طريقة الحق، نستمر طريقة المصالحة، نستمر طريقة الخير البغير وجه البغير بطال من جنوب السودان. فهذه رسالتي لشعب جنوب السودان، فشكرا جزيلا.
شكرا جزيلا. كلمة أخيرة، أنت قلت أنه كل شعب جنوب السودان والبلاد تشهد بركات وسلام، والبابا حث الحكومة والمواطنين أنه لازم الناس يتسامى ويتعايشوا، إلى أي مدى الكنيسة جاهزة للاستمرار؟ لأن الكنيسة قادت مجهودات كبيرة من أجل السلام في جنوب السودان، ومعروف منذ عام 1972 الكنيسة كانت راعية للمفاوضات أديس أبابا، وحتى هذه اللحظة الكنيسة تسعى
الكنيسة دي والشعب، الشعب دي والكنيسة، الكنيسة دائما مع الشعب، الكنيسة دائما مع أمة جنوب السودان. ففي أي لحظة، لحظة سلام، في لحظة خارصة، كنيسة مع الشعب، أمة الأديان تكون مع الشعب. فأين هنا في زيارة دي، هنا ككنيسة، دي نقول شكرا لله عشان الله جاء يزورنا في جنوب.
شكرا جزيلا.
شكرا جزيلا.
نحن هنا في مطار جوبا الدولي، حيث جنوب السودان معروف بالتسامح الديني، حيث يلتقي أو يجاور الكنيسة المسجد وكذلك المجلس الإسلامي والمجلس الكنائس، يعملان سويا من أجل السلام والاستقرار. سعيد جدا أن ينضم إلي مولانا شيخ جمعة سعيد علي هنا في مطار جوبا الدولي، وجاء مع إخوتي من رجالات الدين لوداع البابا. مرحبا بك.
أهلا وسهلا بكم الاخوه في اس اس بي سي، وانا بقول لكم ان شاء الله ربنا يبارك ويزيد. احنا هنا في مطار جوبا الدولي في وداع الهبر العظم بابا ورفاقه الكرام الجوفي
بنت. شكرا جزيلا شيخ جمعه، هذه لحظه تاريخيه. الان بوب فرانسيس يتوجه الى مطار الى طائرته، ونحن وانتم مشاهدي الكرام الان نتابع هذه اللحظات التاريخيه، حيث رئيس الجمهوريه مع بابا فرانسيس الان يتجه نحو الطائره البابويه، ومن ثم الإقلاع إلى 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 العاصمة الإيطالية روما أو دولة الفاتيكان. إذن كونوا معي وتابعوا معنا هذه اللحظات التاريخية مشاهدي الكرام. نحن الآن بمطار جوبا الدولي، بابا فرانسيس يتوجه إلى طائرته، ورئيس الجمهورية يصاحبه إلى طائرته. هذه اللحظات التاريخية مشاهدي الكرام، نحن نأتيكم على الهواء مباشرة بمطار جوبا الدولي، حيث رئيس الجمهورية سلفا كير ميادين إذن مشاهدي الكرام، نحن الآن بمطار جوبا الدولي ونتابع معكم هذه اللحظات التاريخية. الآن النشيد الوطني بابا فرانسيس يدي التهية يحيي العلم البلاد. إذن مشاهدي الكرام، نحييكم في مطار جوبا الدولي وهذه اللحظات التاريخية، حيث يودع البلاد الآن بابا فرانسيس الذي مكث 3 أيام وأجرى لقاءات ستكون لها تأثيرات إيجابية على صعيد البلاد. ألتقي إلى زميل غوري مرة أخرى. غوري، الميكروفون لك.
Yes, viewers of SSBC, you're still watching us live from Juba International Airport. This is we're seeing off His Holiness Pope Francis along with His Excellency President, who is actually leading the government delegation to see off His Holiness Pope Francis. This has been one of the unique day in the history of the Republic of South Sudan, and we're expecting that this visit would be fruitful and it will result to peace, unity and stability of the people of South Sudan. This is what is happening, viewers. As you're seeing, His Excellency President Salva Kiir Mayardit is seeing off His Holiness, and he's been giving the final blessing as they are shaking hands, and His Holiness is giving people of South Sudan through His Excellency Salva Kiir Mayardit. As we're seeing, this is one of the unique day in the history of the Republic of South Sudan, and we are seeing that the people from all walks of life came here to be able to witness this event. This is what is happening, viewers, as we are relaying to you. And we're seeing that His Holiness is finally departing. He's about to board the plane, as you're seeing him on the wheelchair being taken to be able to board the plane. That is Italian Airways boarding from Juba International Airport, heading back to Italy, where he will finally say goodbye to the nation that he said he loved the most. And he said this country is blessed with a lot of resources and wealth that need to be utilized for the benefit of the people of South Sudan. Viewers, we are still here live from Juba International Airport, one of the unique event that you have just witnessed in the history of the country. We have all the religious leaders and the government officials are all here witnessing this event. This is what is happening, and His Excellency President Salva Kiir Mayardit, along with other government officials, they are all here, ministers here at Juba International Airport. They have finally given a very farewell and departed message to His Holiness Pope Francis, and we also couldn't forget that the first vice president was among the government officials, and all the ministers came to be able to see off His Holiness Pope Francis. Viewers, this is of course it happened for the first time since the independence of this nation that people, of course there are some bit of ups and downs, but the religious leaders from the three denominations have come to one arena of peace, unity and reconciliation, and they have finally say we have to come and stand with the people of South Sudan in such a situation so that peace and unity can reign. And this is what is happening, and we're just relaying to you. We're just relaying to you what is happening at Juba International Airport, and you are seeing that His Holiness Pope Francis is also boarding as the government officials is just awaiting a few minutes from now for the plane to take off. And this is what is happening, and this is what is happening, viewers, as we are relaying to you this live from Juba International Airport. We are still broadcasting to you live from Juba International Airport. Yes, our viewers of SSBC, we're still, of course, you're seeing this, what is happening. It's a live event at Juba International Airport, where His Holiness has just boarded the plane, and you could see some of his delegation is finally boarding the plane. Italian Airbus Airways, they are leaving from Juba International Airport to Italy, where finally he has given people of South Sudan message of peace. You're just seeing the delegation is boarding, and His Holiness has already boarded the plane. And we're expecting that from this moment, so many things, the blessings that he has come along with other colleagues will remain in this country. And for sure, the government of South Sudan will be blessed, and South Sudan will move to another level. Sheikh, this is what is happening. Viewers, we have just relayed to you this program live on SSBC. This has been one of the unique events which is happening in the country. We say that most of the cases, God has a hand in making sure things got to be put together. And this has been one of the cry of the people of South Sudan. And our viewers, as we're still continuing to relay to you this program, I will welcome my colleague Mawekwal, as we have got Sheikh to say some few words.
شكرا غوري وشكرا لكم مشاهدي الكرام نحن لازلنا معكم في مطار جوبا الدولي حيث نشاهد أنتم ومعنا هذه اللحظة التاريخية وكنا قد التقينا بالشيخ جمعة سعيد الذي كان يتحدث عن النجاح هذه الزيارة وما يتوقع من هذه الزيارة
شكرا جزيلا للإخوة في SSBC وأنا أقول لكم إن شاء الله نحن هنا في مطار جوبا الدولي لوداع الحبر العظم بابا فرانسيس ورفاقه الكرام ونحن هنا في مطار جوبا الدولي حيث يزدحم الناس في وداع هذا الحبر العظم ونحن توقعاتنا في هذه الزيارة أنه إن شاء الله سيكون هناك تغيير لجنوب السودان وخاصة الرسائل التي يعني قدمها الإخوة الكبار الأديان في 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 هذه الزيارة هي كلها نتائج إيجابية وبعد ذلك بعد تقديم هذه الرسائل يفضل بعد ذلك التنفيذ علينا نحن في جنوب السودان هل نحن سمينا وخاصة المجتمع المسيحي هذا الكلام هذه الرسالة كانت شاملة وعامة يعني كنيسة الأسقفية وكنيسة المشيخية وكنيسة الكاثوليكية هذه رسالة عامة لكل من ينتمي إلى هذه الطوائف وبعد ذلك أيضا هي رسالة عامة للجنوبين ككل لأنه كل إنسان بيحب الخير وبيحب السلام هو داخل في هذه الرسائل فلكل واحد منا يعني يشوف مثلا من أي جهة يقدر يطبق هذه الرسائل حتى أنه في نهاية نادرين في نهاية السلام والأمن والاستقرار
شيخ جمعة بابا كان طلب لقاء بكم أنتم في مجلس الإسلام هل التقى بكم؟
نعم بالأمس يعني هو طلب أنه هو داير يلتقي بقيادات الدينية المسلمة في جنوب السودان وفي هذا الصباح نحن التقينا معه وكان رسالته واضحة أنه لابد أنه تعيشوا يعني يكون في تعايش بيناتكم وإخوانكم المسيحيين في دولة جنوب السودان ولابد تناسكوا العمل وحتى يعني تستطيع يعني تبني السلام والاستقرار للشعب في جنوب السودان وخاصة أنتم قادة الأديان واللقاء كان مثمرا وجيدا إن شاء الله في هذا الصباح
مولانا الشيخ جمعة كنت ضيف على SSBC شكرا جزيلا
شكرا جزيلا لكم وبارك الله فيكم جزاكم الله خير
لا زلنا معكم مشاهدي الكرام وأنقل الميكروفون لزميل غوري أنطونا ومع غوري أنطوني ومع ضيفه غوري مرحبا بك مرة أخرى إذن مشاهدي الكرام نحن الآن في مطار جوبا الدولي حيث نشاهد ونتابع معكم هذه اللحظة التاريخية حيث تقلع بعد قليل الطائرة البابوية نحو العاصمة الإيطالية روما أنقل الميكروفون إلى زميل غوري أنطوني
Yes, viewers of SSBC, we are still joined live at Juba International Airport, seeing off His Holiness Pope Francis, and we're joined by Bishop Precious from Lambeck Church. Bishop Precious, you're highly welcome, and we want to hear some few words from you as a man of God, and being here tonight, how do you describe the visit of the three together for the first time?
It's been a dream. It's something you cannot describe. when the idea came to us in 2019, and we managed to get all the political leaders and the religious leaders to Rome, that was part one. And at that meeting, the Pope and the two churches promised to come. This is something that has not happened for over 500 years, as you know. So it is the hand of God on this nation. And we're all grateful to God that the three men could come here and pray for this country, yes, and also bless this land.
So you did, the visit is fruitful. So South Sudan is blessed, is loved by God?
God has poured his blessings on this land. It is now for the people of South Sudan, not just the leaders and the people,
yes,
to receive, to, yes, accept this blessing and live in peace.
Thank you so much, Bishop Precious.
Thank you. God bless you.
God bless you too. Yes, that was Bishop Precious, and he has just told us a very unique words about God. And we are still here, and let's have the Archbishop of Catholic Archdiocese of Juba, that is none other than His Holiness. He's also here, and we'll have some few minute words from him. Dr. Ameo is here, and let's hear what does he see the visit of His Holiness to the country. Dr. Ameo, welcome.
Thank you.
Tell us today how joyful are you, and how do you describe the visit?
I have just said, at last, powerful Master, we have been busy almost all these 2 months, and no rest. But finally, we say, well done to South Sudan, and well done to our churches. We have now seen the three leaders of the churches come together, and the same message is being emphasized, the message of peace and the message of reconciliation. Finally, I would like to add this important message from the Holy Father. Yes. The Holy Father stressed this: you, the people of South Sudan, you need to remain together. You need to be in the same place. You need to share everything of your life so that peace can be a reality. It is only by caring our brothers and sisters that we can really realize this peace. Yeah.
After we're seeing of His Holiness leaving Juba, is our people committed to ensure that whatever is being told by the three religious leaders being put into action?
It is now going to be our task. We have been tasked with my brother here, Archbishop Justin, that we are to follow up. Yes. And we hope that all our leaders, political leaders, listen to the message of the Holy Father properly, listen to the message of His Grace Justin Welby, and His Grace also.
Thank you so much, Bishop.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, Bishop, what do you say? Summary about what happened, the visit.
In summary, I say thanks be to God for making everything possible. Yes. The leaders have come. They planted the seeds. It is now our responsibility to water the seeds of peace, reconciliation, so that it grows, yes, in a healthy way to help the nation. And I really want to express on behalf of the Episcopal Church of South Sudan our appreciation to our government for facilitating and making everything possible for the visit to happen. And secondly, my thanks goes to all our Christians for coming in big numbers to receive our leaders and to welcome them and to pray with them. I say thank you. Those messages be in our heart, and let's implement them.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, the media team.
Thank you so much. Still, we're watching live, relaying to you this program live from Juba International Airport, where we're expecting this plane. It will be taking off in the next few seconds. This is Airways, Italy Airways, Airbus, that is leaving from Juba International Airport in the next few minutes to Italy, carrying His Holiness Pope Francis alongside with his entourage.
We, of course, viewers, we have seen that the government officials, people from all walks of life, all turn up at Juba International Airport to be part and partial of this event. And we say God has finally remembered people of South Sudan, has remembered this nation, and it's upon the people of South Sudan to make sure that the message that His Holiness finally gave to people of South Sudan is put into action, and this country move from the dawn of peace, stability, and prosperity. This has been one of the unique and great event in the history of the country, and people from all walks of life are here to witness the next few minutes. Viewers, we will be seeing that taking off from Juba International Airport. Let me hear that people have made the day as one of the unique day in the history of the Republic of South Sudan. Viewers, from the beginning, we have reminded you that this day was actually declared and told by the three religious leaders that it's one of the greatest day in the history of the Republic of South Sudan. And we're just seeing the plane, that is Italian Airways, leaving Juba International Airport, finally departing to Italy, where His Holiness Pope Francis, along with his accompanying delegation, are all on board Juba to Italy. And of course, our viewers, we say it from the first day he came to Juba, he number of program alongside with his other three religious leaders, where they held a very, very fruitful meetings, starting with the government officials, moving to church leaders, moving to Christians, organizing two consecutive prayers. One was yesterday at Dr. John Garang Museum, and the other one was also this morning at Dr. John Garang Museum, where South Sudanese from all walks of life received blessings of God. And finally, they were told to love each other, they were told to forgive each other, they were told to unite their and work for the movement of this nation to the path of peace, unity, and stability. We're just seeing the plane has finally gone to the runway as we're expecting. In a second, the plane will be taken off as people, of course, from headed by the head of state, of course, that is His Excellency Salva Kiir Mayardit, happened to be one of the people, one of the Christian. He is also a dedicated Catholic Christian who happened to be among the people to see off His Holiness Pope Francis alongside with other religious leaders in the country. This event, with the taking off of the plane, will mark that South Sudan is finally blessed with the three presence of the religious leaders who happened to be here for the last 2 days. The messages were cleared, and the messages were concrete. What is the hope that the Pope, alongside with the other two religious leaders, including Dr. Reverend Ian Greenshield of the Church of Scotland, alongside with Dr. Reverend Justin Welby of the Anglican Church, all of them stress on importance of peace and stability of this country. As they leave Juba, they told the leadership and they told the people of South Sudan that what is most important now is to ensure that all the messages they have shown, they have told the people, should be put into action, and then God's presence will for sure prevail in South Sudan. Viewers, you're still seeing the plane is on the runway as we're seeing His Holiness along with his other government delegation or the other church leaders are all leaving Juba International Airport, heading to Italy, that is mainly Vatican, where they will finally see that peace and stability reign in the country. Viewers, we're still moving along around here at Juba International Airport, where we are actually giving you some of the Vox Pop. Let's hear Vox Pop from other government officials and people of goodwill, of course, especially those who attended this event. Let's hear from them how significant is this event and how grateful is it as we're seeing the plane of His Holiness on the runway about to take off from Juba to Italy. Let's have Ambassador, who happened to be one of the Christians and happened to attend the event. How do you describe the event, Ambassador?
The event was beyond marvelous. So we, the people of the Republic of South Sudan, today or within these 3 days, with the ecumenical peace pilgrimage, we are beyond blessed. So it hasn't happened for over 800 years for His Holiness the Pope, the Archbishop of Canterbury, and the moderator. This is the three major religions or denominations in Christianity coming together, and here in the land of the Republic of South Sudan. So we are blessed.
What message do you tell to people of South Sudan as these religious leaders finally depart the country?
As they depart the country, I believe we all heard what they have shared. They brought to us the message of peace, love, and reconciliation. So now it's us, the people of South Sudan, to reflect peace in our daily life. And basically, I want to encourage the women of South Sudan, the mothers of the nation. We are the ones who are rearing children. So let's raise our children with love, with peace, with compassion, and with what we stand for as Christians.
And finally, the three religious leaders happened to visit South Sudan, and they are leaving the country, and they hope that this message should be put into action. But are you optimistic that finally people of South Sudan will rally with, along with the government, to ensure that whatever said by the religious leaders is put into action?
I'm very much optimistic because the people of the Republic of South Sudan are majority Christians, and we have a history of persecution. We have been persecuted for our religion. So I'm very sure with this global encouragement by eminent religious leaders has rejuvenated the love and the compassion in us, especially for our land, so that we give South Sudan the love it deserves.
Thank you so much, Ambassador.
Thank you. And actually, when Pope John II visited Sudan, Khartoum, by then I was in seventh grade, and I was among the children that received him. So, and by then the country was one. So the people of South Sudan are blessed for the second time in history to be visited by His Holiness the Pope, and this time is so special, is an ecumenical visit.
Thank you so much. Yes, viewers of SSBC, yes, you're still joining us. We're just seeing off. This is the plane, Italian Airways, finally taking His Holiness Pope Francis. We're just seeing the plane taking off, saying bye-bye to the people of South Sudan, and he has left his grace and blessings upon the country and the people of South Sudan. It has been one of the remarkable days in the history of the country. We have received the three religious leaders all in this country, ranging from the Anglican Church, coming to the Church of Scotland, led by His Holiness, or the Reverend Dr. Ian Greenshield and Dr. Justin Welby of Anglican Church. This was one of the unique days. The message that the people left behind, the men of God left behind, it's unity, it's prosperity, it's forgiveness, it's peace and reconciliation among the people of South Sudan. And it has been so, so, so...